Visit astlessons.com for lyrics and chords, sheet music, tablatures, useful links, and much more.
Hi, so I'm Robert from AST Lessons. Today I'm going to show you how to play Ayo Technology with Milow, which is originally a 50 cent song. The key is B minor with the capo on the 7th fret and E minor without. The average tempo is either 129 or 64 to 65 BPM, depending how you choose to count. This tutorial is for the rhythm guitar, which is the one Jonathan's playing. Main focus will be on the album version, but I will also include a few things from two live performances. As always, remember the timestamps below and the free papers on the website. Okay, so let's start with the chords. First we have an E minor, which you can either play like this, or this, after that a D, and then we have a C. On the D and C, you can either use your thumb to mute the strings with X's, or just try not to hit them. When I play it myself, I only mute the E string, mainly because I have a hard time reaching the A string. But since the A is in the D major triad, it will still sound okay if you happen to hit it. And now on to the strumming. He mostly plays without the plectrum, but I will use one anyway, since it's easier to follow the strums. The main pattern is used for most of the song, but sometimes he alternates with the secondary. So number one sounds like this. And slowly. And number two. And slowly. So the muting is done on the offbeats, which is the ends. So this muting technique, which can also be called percussive strumming, is done by placing the side of your hand over the strings at the same time you're doing the down strum. If you need help with this, I'll put the temporary link in the description to the best lesson I can find. And when I start doing those kind of tutorials myself, I will replace it with my own. But you can also simplify the patterns and skip the muting, so they sound like this instead. Number one. And slowly. Number two. And slowly. Alright, so the only part that is different from the rest of the song is the stick. On the album version, it is covered by the bass guitar and percussions, but live, he often keeps playing the same patterns. So for these reasons, I only feel the need to demonstrate one part, But as always, the full song is available on the LC paper on the website. An extra thing you can do, that he does, both live and on the album, is to do a hammer-on on some of the C's, like this. If anyone wishes to know the exact places, just write the comment and I'll find a way to show you. So in this song, the LC plus paper tells you how many rounds of the patterns you play in each of the chords, but I've also underlined two of the D chords. On the first one, you simply strum the chord once and let it ring, but on the second D, you play like this. So it's slowly. Then on the last E minor of the song, you strum freely from the low E string to the B string. Alright, so the first thing you can do is to replace the D with the D sus 2. And then I've also seen him play the stick like this with muffles between the chords. And another thing you can do is to play without the capo and play these bar chords instead. So B minor, 7th fret, replace E minor. A, 5th fret, replace D. And G, 3rd fret, replace C. And if anyone wants this version on paper, just let me know.